Hi! Today I'm doing a review on a YA series, a young adult series, by Kelly Keaton, and it's called the Gods and Monsters series, and so far there are 2 books in it, and there will be a 3rd one, but I'm not sure when that's out yet. Okay, so this series, I think, has loads of potential. Like, the first half of the first book I absolutely loved, but like, the author brings in a lot of elements, and sometimes it's just an element too far. So I'll explain what the plot is about. And it's about a girl called Ari, and she's always been different her whole life, and she's been in foster homes since she was 4 years old, and she has very, very long, white, almost silver-like hair, and teal eyes. And then she's 17, I think, at the start of the book, and she decides to go investigate what happened to her parents and why she was up for adoption. And then she ends up going to this town called New Two, which is the New Orleans of the future. So it's set in kind of the distant future. And when she goes there, it's like segregated from the rest of America, and it's just its own little private kind of place. And all she realizes, there's all kind of like freaks there as well, like her, and she's not just the only weird one. And then she discovers all these things that happen in that town, and she gets into kind of magical trouble over the 2 books. So I loved the first half of the first book. The author set up a real kind of unique imaginative world, and it is in the future, but it doesn't have too much of a dystopian feel. It has more of kind of a paranormal feel, because there's all different types of creatures in this series. But then when I get to about halfway through the first book, even more like not just paranormal stuff, but mythology stuff is brought into it, which I think goes a step far. And then we have so much interesting storyline with Ari herself, like with her whole background, her parents, her personal life, that could form like a whole series by itself. So I do think the author tried a little bit too hard. I mean, A for effort, she put a lot into it, the author, but Kelly, but it's just a bit too much. It's a bit chaotic and all over the place. And as well, sometimes it feels very forced and rushed. Like, she's there a few days and she already has family, you know, and relationships are formed very quickly and very unrealistically at a fast pace. Like, she meets a character and on one chapter, he's very sullen and reluctant to be nice to her even. And the next chapter, they're laughing and smiling and getting along great. So there's no development in between, and I'm a stickler for the development of relationships, and I want them to be authentic and realistic. Unfortunately, they're not in this series, and I think more in the second book, Ari wasn't as likeable as a character. I realised recently that it's harder to find a likeable YA protagonist than an adult series protagonist, and there's a good baddie in this series, like, but I'm not sure how long the author's going to drag it out. Like, are they just going to have the same fight at the end of every book with the baddie getting away again? I'm not sure. But while I was reading the first half of the first book, I just got such an excited feel for it. And I was like, oh, this series is going to be great. I'm so happy I discovered it. Because there was such a just interesting story formed with this great bunch of characters, but then it just, as I said, it got a little bit rushed and a lot was brought in. Would I recommend this series? Because I like the first half of the first book so much, I'd recommend the first book. But and then you decide for yourself how you felt the change went, you know, in the second half. And if you didn't like it, the second book is actually worse than the first book. Worse is such a strong word. Let's just say I like the second book less than the first one. But it's up to you. Like, read the first one and see what you think. And if you're not mad about it, don't bother with the second one, because the second one is just kind of the same. But there is excitement in there, and as I said, loads of potential. I mean, like, if the author just edited a little bit more and just picked out certain points, elements of the story, and as a main character, and made a series with that, it could be excellent. But just shoving everything in there is just a little bit too much. So that is my spoiler-free review. Okay, now I'm going to do a spoiler review. If you haven't read the series before, I suggest you switch off now. It was fine that in New 2 we had the three main races. So we had vampires, we had witches, and we had the shifters, or slash demigods. Forget the demigods for now. But yeah, I thought it was fine. Like, it wasn't too much, it was just okay. And then the whole Greek mythology thing was brought in with Athena, and I was like, what? I was just hoping it was just the character called Athena. I was really hoping it wasn't the Greek wise god, Athena. Then it turned out to be yes. I was like, oh no. Like, I think Percy Jackson is going to be the go-to series to compare, and nothing is going to be as good as the Percy Jackson series in that case. There's also the goddess test, which is very inferior to that. But yeah, so there was no need to bring in all that Greek mythology when we already had all the paranormal stuff. So again, just an element too far. And then as well, we had all this different background with Ari. Okay, so we had Ari is a child who was in foster care her whole life, and she kind of keeps hinting at that was a really tough time. And then we have her whole mother who killed herself when she was 21, and the curse that would get all the females in her generation will all end up dying at 21, and they will all give birth to a daughter. That kind of reminded me of the Hunter Kiss series. So that was another big element to get that curse off. You could have a whole series dedicated to that. And then as well, we have to find out that her father is a hunter, and that's like a big forbidden thing. So we have this big thing with her father as well, which could be another series. And then we also have her in the Nine Families and going to that new school, which other series have just formed on characters going to this like supernatural school. So then I was like, this is a lot. And then we have her having her family with all these strange freaks. So yeah, actually that's another thing, having these just like random kind of freaks, like people with weird color eyes and teeth and hair, like they don't really fit into any category. So yeah, that was another thing. Then her relationship with Sebastian, as I said, if it was treated well, it could make the series a bit more mature, but it was treated very rushed, and like they knew each other a couple of hours and they were already kissing and in love, and that's one of the things I hate. Like, at first, like, he was quite grumpy with her, and I was like, oh, it's going to take a while for him to kind of warm up to her. But the minute he took her out around the city, he was grabbing her. It was quite strange. As well, like, in the second book, she was like, I have to save the people I love from Athena. And the people she loves were a father she doesn't even remember meeting, and a child, Violet, who she knew for about 2 days. Just little comments like that really bug me. I mean, she doesn't really know these people. Yeah, I kind of like at the end of the second book as well how her dad just wanted to stay around to get to know her. That was quite sweet. And I liked Michael too. Yeah, like a lot of things were rushed, the whole Michael and Sebastian thing as well. Yeah, so I'm looking forward to the third book. I'm hoping the author will like fix up all these things, maybe cut back on some. It's kind of impossible to cut back now if she brought them all in there. The more I read about Athena, like, yes, she's scary, but I'm just I'm kind of sick of her now. I just wanted to defeat her already, but that's going to take a while. I'm not 100% sure about that curse. The curse wasn't treated very well. It wasn't very straightforward. Yeah, so I do have a few issues with the series, but I mean, there's always something good in there. You just have to try and find it and have the author pluck it out and amplify it, and hoping the next book. But that's my review on the Gods and Monsters series. I'd love to know what you think about it, and let me know your opinion. And that's my review for today. So thank you very much for watching, and I hope you tune in to my next review.